Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. And in today's video, I want to try out my Spyder MR6 68 caliber paintball marker using the set RAM Slugs, the set 68 Slugs from setram.net. So already lubricated the slugs, so they are a bit sticky. I just tested loading the slugs normally, not with the first one with the point up, but just push it down normally, and it seems to be feeding just fine. So I will try that first, see how it goes. I have 6 of these slugs. You can see they are lining up nicely there. And on this marker, I have changed the adapter for the air tank or CO2 tank from sitting on the grip, under the grip, and up to the side here. I think it looks better, and instead of having something clumsy hanging around here, I got it all in the front where the grip is. So 12 gram CO2 adapter, and that should give me just about 20 shots, I think it was, in total. Humerix band CO2 canister, and let me take some silicone spray on the seal there. This adapter is quite old, so I hope it won't leak. After all, the seals deteriorate after some time. So I will not puncture it just yet. I'll just put it in snug like so. And in the magazine like so. Now let me rig up the ball trap. I think this will shoot rather slow, so no point in shooting at tin cans, but I have a beer can here. We can see if we can make some holes in that one, and I will measure the velocity with my X-ray diachronic. One moment.
Okay, I have no gas it up. Let's see what the velocity will be with 8.5 gram slug. That's 130 grain. Shot number one. 166. And as you can see, in there and out there. Let me fish out the slug. Here it is. Let's try that again. .171. I think I will fish them out, so don't shoot slug on slug. .168. So the velocity seems to be quite stable. Entry, exit, and there's the slug. before. 165. This is a normal paintball gun. Not like this super-tuned HDR or Tiberius or anything. So, if you have a normal paintball gun, this is the velocity you will achieve with these slugs. So, two more shots. Here's the slug.
Okay, an awesome shot, so you can see me shoot. And let's see. .166.
And it entered here. Let me try a shot at the bottom of the can. .163. And it shot a hole in the bottom of the can there. And there's the slug. So it has plenty of energy, even in this marker. .163. And more gaping holes. Starting to drop a bit. .149. .160. Where's that slug? There it is. .160 again, and now I cut the can in half. I just put the pieces back in there. So, should be one more slug. .156. So, let me do a little reload again. So,
load it up again. I think this will be the final shots. .159. just for the heck of it, let me try a couple of shots like this. Can't use the sights actually, because they will overshoot. Maybe not at this distance. So let's see. And it should be out of ammo. It is. So, when loading, to make sure you don't get any jams, you can load it normally. But when you push in the next round, you see it has a ring in the front and the rear there of the slug. You must make sure that the next slug rests on top of those rings. Otherwise, the slug will tilt and jam the bolt. So if you load it properly, you shouldn't have any issues. Like so. Not sure how much CO2 is left, but let me take whatever shots that I can get out of it. 147. I just shoot in different places on the bolt trap there. 140. Need to straighten it up. /132, /122, /112, /103, and we are out of CO2 gas. So, as you could see, devastating effect on a pop can. Shredded it completely in pieces. So big thanks to Daniel from Zetram.net for sending me the slugs. And in this marker I loaded the slugs normally. In his manual he says to load first one with a point up and then the rest normally. But using it in this Spyder MR6, it functions normally. I could just load all the slugs normally. And I think this time I got just over 20 shots, maybe 23 shots in total. So yeah, not too bad from one CO2 canister. Quite cool marker. Yes. So make sure you check out Zetram.net. And have a look at these cool slugs. 8.5 gram or 130 grains, and they are CNC machined. Very nicely made. So if you're having paintball markers, make sure you have the type that takes first strike balls or paintballs. Because these things will not fit inside a normal paintball magazine using paintballs. So you need a MagFed marker like the one I used today. So yeah, quite cool. Not sure if they still make this marker, but I had it for several years now and never had any problems with it. So quite cool. M4 replica. Yes. Okay. Hope you liked the video. See you another time. And thank you for watching.